Okay, see children, in the last class we have discussed about the weather. Okay, it is a day immediate change and also day to day change is called weather. And also I have told you to collect the 7 days newspaper and collect the details of rainfall, wind speed, humidity and temperature. Yes, so here they have given one graph. See, from 3rd August to 9th August, and the temperature difference will be given in vertically. Okay, so first day 3rd it will be 26 and second 4th August it will be 23.5 and 5th August it will be 25 and 6th August it will be 22 and 7th August it will be 25.8 and 8th August, 9th August. See, there will be a slight changes every day. Okay. See, as it is clear from any weather report, the maximum and minimum temperatures are recorded every day. See, in a whole day, the maximum temperature can be measured during the afternoon. Okay. In the afternoon. In the afternoon only, it will be more hot, so maximum temperature is measured. And the minimum temperature is measured at the early morning. Okay, that is the minimum temperature. So, here, there are some special thermometers are used for this purpose called maximum and minimum temperature. Can you guess when during the day we have the maximum temperature and when the minimum? Yes, the maximum temperature of the day occurs generally in the afternoon and the minimum temperature occurs generally in the early morning. Can you now understand why in summers we feel so miserable in the afternoon and comparatively comfortable early in the morning? So, in summer, usually in a normal days, the afternoon will be hot temperature, okay? But in summer, it will be too hot. So that only people are preferring to move earlier in the summer, okay? And why that is happening? See, one boy is wondering, I wonder why weather changes so frequently. What is the source of weather in the first place? Yes, all changes in the weather. See here. All changes in the weather are caused by sun. The sun is the cute sphere of hot gases at a very high temperature. The distance from the sun from us is very large. Even then, the energy sent out by the sun is so cute, so that is the source of all heat and light on earth. So the sun is the primary source of energy that causes changes in the weather. Energy absorbed and reflected by the earth's surface, oceans and atmosphere plays important role in the determining the weather at any place. If you live near the sea, you would have realized that the weather of your place is different from that of a place in a desert or near a mountain. See, the main source, all the changes in weather is happening only due to the sun. Okay. So the distance between the sun and different countries are different. So that is the main reason for the changes in weather. Okay. So the energy absorbed. See, for example, one country is getting sunlight. Now another country will not get in sunlight. Okay. So in those type of changes also, reason are they included for the factor for a weather. So, see, if you are living in a mountain or if you are living in a desert or if you are living in near the seashore areas, see, the weather will be different, okay? It's everything because of sun, okay? Sun is a primary source of energy that changes that make changes in the weather, okay? Yes. What about the times of sunrise and sunset? You know that in winters it becomes dark early and you do not get much time to play. Are the days shorter in winter than in summer? Try to find out yourself by completing the project given at the end of the chapter. So just find out. See, during the winter time, it gets dark soon. You can take even at the time of 5:36 itself, it gets dark. The sky gets dark. So in those days, is the days are shorter? Just find out whether the days are shorter in winter or not. Okay. Yes. And now we are going to learn about climate. Okay. Meteorologist record the weather every day. See, meteorologist means the person who is recording the weather changes. Okay. Every day. The records of weather have been preserved for past several decades. These help us to determine the weather pattern at a place. So, they'll note the weather changes regularly. Okay, if the weather reports are as it is, similarly looks like same for 1 or 2, 3 or 3 months. So it is a continuous. It is a called climate. Okay. So the average weather pattern taken over a long time, say 25 years, is called the climate of the place. See, for 25 years, if the weather reports are same, looks same for the particular place, for 25 years, it is called climate. Okay. If we find that temperature at a place is high most of the time, then we say that climate is hot. If there is also heavy rainfall on most of the days in the same place, then it is called hot and wet. Okay. So how can we tell that place have a hot climate, this place have a hot and wet climate? How can we say na? If the place has more high temperature for many days. Okay. See, most of the time, if the place is hot, if the temperature is hot, it is a hot climate place. Okay. And if the most that place is getting more rainfall in most of the days, it is a hot and wet climate place. Okay. Yes. So in table 7.213, we have given a climatic conditions at two different places. The mean temperature for a given month is found in two steps. First, we find the average of temperature recorded during the month. Second, we calculate the average of such average temperatures over many years. That gives the mean temperature. The two places are Srinagar in Jammu and Kashmir and Thiruvananthapuram in Kerala. See, Srinagar is a very cold place, okay? And Thiruvananthapuram is a, maybe it can, it is a normal only, but it rains. Okay, it rains more. See here, they have given a temperature, daily minimum temperature and maximum temperature. This is for Srinagar and this is for Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala. Okay, see how much difference. See here, the temperature is in the range of -2.3, 4.7, like that. So those places are very cold. Okay. So here minimum starts from 22 and daily starts at maximum starts at 31. So there is a normal hot and wet climate and rainfall also there. Okay. See, the numbers for the mean total rainfall have been rounded off. Okay. See, here they have given daily minimum and maximum temperature and also rainfall rate also in mm, in millimeter they have given. See, when you compare, which place getting more rainfall? Yes, Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala. Okay. So this is how we will tell that place is a cold place, climate place. This place is a hot and wet climate place, like that. We can differentiate. Okay. So by looking at the tables, we can easily see the difference in the climate of Jammu and Kashmir and Kerala. We can see that Kerala is very hot and wet in comparison to Jammu and Kashmir, which has a moderately hot and wet and climate for the part of the year. Similarly, the data for the western region of India, for example Rajasthan, the temperature is very high during the most part of the year, but during winter, which lasts only for few months, the temperature is quite low. So this region receives very little rainfall. So this is typically desert climate. It is hot and dry. And northeastern India receives rain for a major part of the year, so that we can say that climate of northeast is wet. Okay, children. So Rajasthan and all, it is in the center of the India. Yes or no? So those places only the deserts are there. Okay. So in those places the temperature is most, the sun is so hot for the most of the days. So those places are termed as hot climate. Okay. But in the northeastern countries, northeastern means you can take this side. So those sites are getting more rainfall, so those places will be always getting rainfall in the most of the days. So those places are termed as wet climate. Okay, children, clear? Yes. So today with this we conclude. The remaining we will see next class. Thank you.